and leave the city. I've been praying on some simple Midwest living, homestead instead of my own 9 to 5 with a suit and tie, going off grid with Doug and Stacy.
I just want you to notice the draw. Do you hear that? It sounds like a turbo engine. And that's what you want. A good draw on your fire, any kind of fire you have. I know, right? Now you want to know how it works. So basically what I have here is a stainless steel cylinder. You can see the circle right here. And then there's a barrel, another stainless steel barrel inside of this tube. So it's a tube inside of a tube. I plumbed my water that comes in gravity fed from our rainwater catchment system. Comes right up this pipe, goes right into the bottom of the tank. The fire inside the tank heats the water. The hot water comes out of this. Back down into the shower on a T right there, and then I have two lines running. To the spigots right here so Stacy can do laundry out back. There's also a pressure valve right there because you can actually get the water too hot and cause this to blow. And if that blows, that means all the water inside this tank is gonna go right out of this blow line we have. And trust me, the 5 gallon bucket is not adequate. But it's there for temporary. I'm going to run that line into our gray water out system. Now, one of the questions that we get a lot is, what do we do with our gray water? Gray water is the water that falls to the drain and goes out of your house. And at our place, since we live off grid with no public utilities, there's no sewer lines or anything, and we don't have a septic tank, we actually poop in 5 gallon buckets and we make a composting system out of it. And we're going to show you guys all that coming up as soon as we get through this winter time. So what we do is I trenched in lines out to the forest, and all this water with biodegradable soap that doesn't hurt anything, and all this nice rainwater with no fluoride, chloride, chemicals or anything like that, goes right out to our tree line and waters all of our trees. Pretty much just like any shower, we have our hot and our cold. And this is like the mixing tube. And then I put in this copper pipe here, and Gary came and helped me put this together. I designed it and he kind of soldered it, and we worked together to put it together. And then this tube comes up as the water's mixing, and then it hits these two copper pipes, and I drilled holes in the pipes, and that's our shower. Stacy and I are big proponents of taking cold showers. Okay, this is a warm shower that we use during the winter time because obviously we don't have access to our cold water shower that we rigged up outside. If you guys stick around and you subscribe to our channel, as the spring comes and summer comes, we'll show you all of our systems and show you how you could even set up an outdoor rainwater shower right in your own backyard. All this to say that Stacy and I got off grid. We gritted it out. We learned all the old ways, all the hard ways. And now we're slowly starting to implement systems that are going to make our life a little easier. So if any of our systems fail, which they have, we'll be able to jump right back into primitive and handle our situation because we have grit built up. That's one thing people are missing today is the grit. Yeah, the sun's really coming up now. You guys got to have shower day with me. If you got any questions, you can leave them down in the comment section below, okay? But this is our rainwater off-grid, you know, shower. It's all gravity-fed, 100%. I collect all the rainwater from the big barn up there. I trenched the lines in the ground to the log cabin next door, and then I broke a line off at the out here in the ground when we built this place. And that line comes in here, and I just showed you all the hookup of it. So this building that we added on to our property after 11 years basically houses our solar power for our property. It takes care of the root cellar so we can store our food, and it has the hot water for our hot water shower during the winter time. And we don't take very hot water showers in the winter time. We just add a little hot water to it, you know, so we're not super freezing. But sometimes it's nice just to take a real nice hot shower to kind of open yourself up and kind of relax your muscles. But for the most part, Stacy and I subscribe to the cold shower theory. If you guys haven't checked that out, you could check out Wim Hof on YouTube, and just understand that it's not actually about taking a cold shower. The whole trick to everything is the breathing. And that's really what you're learning with the cold showers, is how to breathe. How to slow your body down. Which a lot of people have no control over themselves anymore, really. And that's kind of sad. So you guys know how my gravity-fed hot water shower works and how Stacy and I get ourselves all cleaned up in the wintertime. I got to go do my chores, check in on the new baby lambs. That's it. So hopefully you guys, you know, picked up some nuggets on this video. If you guys got any questions, just leave them down in the comment section below. Stacy and I are watching the comment section a lot lately, especially because we're trying to answer your questions, and we're also giving away a Ford F-150. It's a 2014, 150,000 mile 4x4 with a 6 foot plus bed on it. It's got the longer bed. It's not one of those little short beds. And we're giving that away at the end of this month. You have to be subscribed to our YouTube channel, and you have to go to Off Grid with Doug and Stacy to register, and we'll get a hold of you guys at the end of the month. Do not fall for any Telegram or Telegraph or any other scams. We will not contact you, and we never ask you for money. If you guys found this information valuable, give me a thumbs up on the way out. Make sure you're subscribed. Tell your friends. Show them how we live. We're living off-grid without the man, and we're showing you all of our systems that you guys can put in place for your place. And, you know, maybe if you can't do it, maybe you could just tell somebody about it. Maybe you can't do everything that we show you, but you should know everything that you could do. All right? You guys have a great day. See you on the next video.
Did you guys know that in the 16, 17, and 1800s, chocolate was consumed as a beverage? There was no such thing as a chocolate candy bar. Well, we're bringing chocolate tea back to the 21st century because it's loaded with antioxidants our body loves, and it's a great source of magnesium that's wonderful for bone and heart health. It's a great addition to your coffee machine or your French press, or just along with your favorite sweetener. You can find it at offgridwithdougandstacy.com, along with our brand new tea infuser, simple to use for easy steeping. Cheers!